Good morning, children. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Myself, Sanmesh, and today we are going to discuss Class 8 Physics Assignment, which was given to you on 2nd July. This assignment is based on the chapter Structure of Earth. So let us start with our assignment. So our first question is, how do people know what's in the Earth's core? Have people dug down? So the answer is no. No one has really dug down deep into the Earth's core. But there are scientific theories which tells us that the Earth's core, especially the outer core of the Earth, is made up of molten metals. Molten metals like nickel, iron, etc. Now, these metals are, they have high number of electrons. Okay, metals have large number of electrons. And these molten metals, they rotate in the direction opposite to the direction of rotation of Earth. So they are rotating in the direction opposite to the direction of rotation of Earth. So due to the rotation of these molten metals, there is a generation of conventional electricity inside the Earth's core. Okay. Now, whenever there is an electricity, obviously there is going to be a magnetic field. So that's how Earth has its own magnetic field due to the rotation of these molten metals. That's why Earth behaves, we can call Earth like a giant electromagnet. So we can say that Earth behaves like a giant electromagnet. So the answer to this question which I've written is, the answer is first of all, no. No one has yet dug down to the Earth's center. There is only a scientific assumption that the core of the Earth consists of molten metals that rotate opposite to the direction to the rotation of Earth. Okay. Now, due to the rotation, there is a generation of conventional electric current. And due to that, the Earth behaves like a giant electromagnet. So the magnetic field of the Earth is due to the rotation of the core. I hope the point is clear. Let us proceed further to our next question. Question number two, how do people know about Earth's interior? Again, I repeat the question, how do people know about Earth's interior? Now, there are various sources using which we can gather information about the Earth's interior. Few of them I have listed here. They are, first of all, by studying meteorites. Okay, by study of meteorites will give us the information about the Earth's interior. Next is the direct observation of the rocks originate from the depth. The rocks which are originating from the depth of the Earth, they carry information about the core. So by studying them, we can gather again information about the core. Also, there are various experiments which are conducted at high pressure. Okay, high pressure experiments. And also by studying earthquake waves or the seismic waves which are produced during the earthquakes, they also give us a lot of information about the interior of the Earth. Okay, so I hope you are clear with this question. So let us proceed further to our next question. Now, what is the coolest layer of the Earth? Again, I repeat the question. What is the coolest layer of the Earth? Now, Earth is divided into different layers. Now, this layering is such that the outer layer is the crust. And the outermost layer is the crust. And after that, we have mantle. And then we have core. Again, the core is divided into two parts. One is the outer core. And then we have our inner core. Okay. Now, the outermost layer is the crust. Okay. The outermost layer is the crust on which we actually live. Right now, we live on the crust of the Earth. Now, this layer, we can say that it is the coolest layer amongst the other layers of the Earth. Now, the temperature, this cool temperature, it allows us to survive on the crust. So, all the other layers are hotter as compared to the crust. So, technically speaking, the coolest layer of the Earth is the crust. Now, crust is the layer on which we live actually and is exposed to the cool temperature that allow us to live. So, due to the suitable temperature, we are able to survive on the crust. I hope the point is clear. Let us proceed. Question number four. What layer of the Earth is made up of molten iron and nickel? Again, I repeat the question. What layer of the earth is made up of molten iron and nickel? Now, this we have already discussed that the core of the earth is divided into two parts. First is the outer core and then the inner core. The outer core is actually in liquid state. It is made up of molten iron and the nickel. Okay. So, it is the outer core which is made up of molten iron and the nickel. I have highlighted this point. I hope the point is clear. Let us proceed to our next question. Now, which is the thinnest layer of the earth? Again, I repeat the question. Which is the thinnest layer of the earth? The answer is again the crust. Okay. Now, the crust amounts for only 1% of the entire volume of the earth. So, we can say that the crust is the thinnest layer of the earth. Amongst the, all the layers, crust is the thinnest layer. Crust is the thinnest layer of the earth, amounting for less than 1% of the entire volume. Again, I hope the point is clear. Let us proceed to our last question. Now, how do we know that the outer core of the earth is liquid? How do we know that the outer core of the earth is liquid? Again, the credit goes to our seismic waves. Now, seismic waves, they are generated when there is an earthquake. Okay. And there are two types of earthquake waves. One is the S wave and another one is the P wave. The P wave is nothing but our primary wave, which is recorded first in the seismograph, followed by the secondary wave. And then the last one is the surface wave. Okay. We don't have to worry about the surface wave right now. Now, this primary wave, it is a longitudinal wave. Okay. It is a longitudinal wave and it can pass through liquids. Whereas secondary wave, it is a transverse wave. So it cannot pass through liquid. Secondary wave or the S wave, it cannot pass through liquid. Now, scientists figured out that the outer core must be liquid because the S wave, okay, the S wave, it does not pass through it. Since it is liquid, S wave cannot pass through it, but the P wave do pass through the outer core. So using this, we can conclude that the outer core is made up of liquid. It's actually in liquid state. Also, the behavior of P and S wave, they also indicate that the inner core is solid. They also give us information that the inner core is a solid part. And how do we actually know all this is because the speed of seismic wave, this P and S wave, they depend upon the density of the material through which they are traveling. Okay. So whenever this P and S wave, they are traveling inside the cores. Okay. Their speed is affected by their densities. That's how we come to know whether there is a variation in density in our layering of the earth or not. Okay. I hope the point is clear to you all. Thank you all. Thank you so much.